In this video, we're going to discuss the Lacerte synchronization, and we're going to talk about how to set it up, and we're going to do some imports. One consideration that I want to talk about real briefly before we begin is if you're doing an import from a single synchronization, meaning you're going to import your contact data only from Lacerte or only from one of our other integrated tools, such as the QuickBooks Sync, the Excel importer, and so on, then that's fine. These tutorials will cover all the bases, and you should be set. If for some reason, though, you're going to be importing contact data from multiple sources, for example, from Lacerte and from QuickBooks, I would highly recommend that you contact our trainers to discuss best practices. Anytime you're using multiple sets of data and you're mixing those together into a single area, there's considerations, duplications, and age of the data, and so on. So I highly recommend that you contact our trainers and have them assist you in that import. So to talk about the Lacerte integration here, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and get it set up. So to begin, just navigate to the Setup menu at the top, My Company, Information and Settings, and this is where we house all of our integrations. They're located down here in the bottom right corner. So for this tutorial, we're actually going to go directly to Lacerte, and here's where we're going to set up a lot of our default values and our options. The first thing you're going to do is locate the Lacerte directory. Now this would be for the current year. Now the version of Lacerte I have is 12, but obviously you'd want to point it to 13 or 14 or 15, whatever the appropriate year would be. So we're going to go ahead and do that and simply just navigate to the location of our Lacerte file. There we go. We're going to use 12 tax in this example. Choose the correct year over here on the right. And there we go. Just below that is where we can choose our Lacerte executable. And the reason you'd want to do this is inside of Office Tools, as you begin using projects, you can actually display the Lacerte statuses inside the project screen. And from that link, you're able to actually open up Lacerte and it will navigate to the contact for you. In order for that function to work, you're gonna wanna map it to the local path of your Lacerte file. And that's typically on the C drive. Just below that, you can choose the contact types you'd like to update and the entities. This is very important. You're gonna wanna have a look at this just to make sure not only are you including all the entities that you have in Lacerte, but that everything is mapped or the way it should be. That's exactly what we have here, so we can go ahead and save that. So that's the connection portion of the Lacerte sync. Once we've done that, now we have these other options down at the bottom of the screen. Most of these are pretty self-explanatory, but I'm going to talk about a few of them. One of the most obvious ones is to allow the updating of Lacerte files after the tax file has been locked. Now this is an option that's going to vary from office to office. In some circumstances, once the file is locked, the return is done, and there's no need to make any changes. Other offices like to have that information updated even after it's locked, and obviously you can make that decision and check the box accordingly. Okay, same goes along with the allow syncing of password protected Lacerte clients. You may also want to use an upper lowercase, and really what that means is typically a lot of offices will have Lacerte in the uppercase format. This can manage that for you and import those and manage those in a lowercase or upper lowercase inside of Office Tools. Okay, over on the right, there's an area here to update Lacerte when adding or editing contact information. Now, this is very important. This is really where the live synchronization comes into play. And what it means is when you update Office Tools, it will go ahead and update Lacerte. Now, you have two choices here. One is to have that function happen silently, and the other is for it to prompt you. Just a recommendation, if this is the first time using the utility, I would actually recommend using the prompt. The reason being is as staff begin using the practice management workspace and they get more familiar with how editing contact information is going to work, they're seeing the prompts and they can go ahead and obviously acknowledge that change. But as time goes on, you get more comfortable with what's going to happen in the updating and editing of contact info, you may want to switch that over to silent. That way it just simply happens seamlessly in the background. And there's another option over here to create a project when creating a Lacerte client, and this will do just that. It'll allow Office Tools to actually make projects for you after they've been defined in the system. It'll actually allow you to create projects in the system when creating a new Lacerte client. So once all that's done, you're set. Simply just say OK. And now what you've done is you've set up and connected your Lacerte file to the PM workspace. Now we're going to talk about importing contacts into Office Tools from Lacerte. So once you've made the connection through the integration setup window, you can now actually come to the Contacts menu at the top of the screen. Import, Export Contacts, and Lacerte Sync. Now here you have a lot of options, and obviously depending on what you need to do, you can make the appropriate choice. In this example, we're going to go ahead and do an import. We have a brand new practice management workspace with no contacts, and we can actually see an empty list over here on the left. So we're going to go ahead and import contacts from Lacerte. Again, it's our tax software. The data is usually very current and accurate, so that's a good place to start. So we go to the contacts menu, import, export contacts, Lacerte, and again, we're agree with a couple options here. We can export unsynced, meaning we've created contacts in Office Tools. We now want to push them to Lacerte. That's something that you're going to do on a routine basis after you've done this. It's more of a maintenance. Or you can match contacts. That's where, for example, maybe you have an existing practice management contact list and an existing Lacerte list, and you want to go ahead and match those two together. In this example, we're going to go ahead and do the import of contacts. So what this is going to do after it scans Lacerte is give you a window that will allow you to make a couple decisions as far as pushing to or pulling from Lacerte or syncing in both directions. So in this screen, what we're seeing is we're seeing all of the Lacerte contacts, account numbers, names, even their entity types. So what we're going to do in this tutorial is we're going to choose the Import Lacerte function here on the bottom and click Import Selected. Now, as time goes on, you may want to revisit this screen and either synchronize in both directions to update that contact data, or if you need to, you can actually export and push that into Lacerte. Okay, you can select specific entity types also. So, for example, if we weren't doing an overall import, we could be very specific and grab a very specific entity type if we need to. But again, for this example, we're going to do Import Lacerte and Import Selected. One recommendation I'd make at this screen before you do the import is maybe give a look to your Lacerte contacts. The reason being is there's a lot of times where contacts are set up in Lacerte for various reasons. Maybe it's amended returns, extensions, and so on. You may want to exclude those from this import. Now, you can obviously always remove them later after the fact, but if you take the time to do it on this screen, it might save you some effort on the other end. The best way to do that is to actually unselect all the contacts and then go through your list. And when you come across somebody that you do not want to import and they're a duplicate in Lacerte for one reason or another, just simply select them off the list here. Okay, and work your way down through your list. And once you're satisfied that you have your exclusionary list of contacts selected, you can actually just hit hide. They'll come off the list and they won't bother you in the future. So once you're happy with the contacts that you're about to import, we're going to go ahead and say select all and import the selected contacts. This is a prompt that you'll get about creating projects when you're importing from Lacerte. If this is the very, very first time you're doing this and you haven't gone through the project setup inside of the practice management workspace, I would say no to this. The reason being is you don't want a bunch of projects created in the system that haven't been set up yet, because then you'd have to go and then delete them, and that could be kind of a mess. So for this instance, I would go ahead and say no. You can always create projects later in bulk after the fact. So we're going to go ahead and say no. And based on how many contacts you may have, it could take a minute or two. We don't have many in here, so this is going to go pretty quick. But when you're talking 600-700 contacts perhaps, this might be a good opportunity to go get a cup of coffee. But once all that's done, it'll go ahead and give you a quick update on how many it's been able to import. And we say okay.